Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Selita, aka Joe, and today I am back with another video. I will be sharing a Jamaican brown stew recipe. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Like, subscribe, comment, and share this video. If you're returning to my channel, thank you for supporting. Continue to like, continue to comment, and continue to share my videos. Stay tuned. Come on. So guys, I already pre-seasoned my fish. And like I said, we're here to do another recipe showcasing my Jamaican cooking skill. So here, all the fish. I have two fishes. Is that a word? No. I have two fish in the bowl and already seasoned. I cut it because I want the season to soak into it. For those who know me, they will tell you that I pre-season my fish or any meat for that matter and put it in the fridge. So I will have to do a video to show you how I prepare it and clean up my meat and season it and all those stuff. And I am currently set up close to my stove, hence you will see that. Currently, I have green, yellow, red, orange bell pepper. I have some chopped onions and, of course, some scotch bonnet pepper. I also have some tomato. And I also have another set of onion, and you will see why when we get into the video. I have here some garlic, because we don't cook without garlic. We have here some garlic, and I also have another set of pepper and garlic and thyme. This is what I'm going to put into the oil to flavor it. I already have my pot heated. So now it's time to pour in that oil and begin the process. The first thing that we are going to do is pour in the oil and allow it to heat up, right? You can allow your oil to heat to a maximum of 355. So guys, I'm just using this little bottle to pour it out. It might take a little while, but yeah, that's how I do it. And I am going to put sufficient oil, not only to cover the bottom, but sufficient oil to cover midway or part of the fish. Some people, they like to put a whole lot of oil to cover the fish. I'm not doing that in this video. You can do it if you want. This is how I do my fish, right? I put sufficient oil that I know I'm able to utilize. I don't go overboard with it, or I don't follow anyone in that sense. I'm doing it this my way, still the Jamaican way, because guess what? You'll end up back with the same fish, type of fish, or style of fish. So yeah, so this is the oil heating. And so the next thing, the step that we're going to do, we are going to get our fish golden brown on both sides. So that's the first thing we're going to do. So while my oil is heating up, I'm gonna let it sit there for about 2 to 3 minutes because the pot was already. So guys, my oil already heated, and I put the pepper and some garlic in the oil along with some thyme. I'm trying to flavor this oil. As you see, the pepper has get, well, it's not really burnt, but this was there for a while. But yeah, I'm just trying to flavor the oil. Then I will show you how I do it. I don't want them to burn, but I won't take them out right now or anything. It's just to flavor the oil. Right, so yeah, I am going to now I might be stretching across because of how my setup is, but I am now going to put my fish inside my pot. So I will be putting one of them like this. Right, the oil is hot, could be a little bit hotter. I'm gonna move around. I'm not gonna put both. I'm gonna do one and show you how to do it. Then I do the other one. I might show you as well as that. Wow. Just be careful of those proper. You don't want to get burned. But yeah. So here, that's one of the fish that is frying in the oil. Hot oil. So yeah. So that's what's happening right there. And I'm gonna let you see what transpire. I want you to see when I turn it, because I want it to be golden brown and I want it to come out really nice. And I want you to see it, see the whole process. I'm trying to film the whole process. I don't want it to be too long, because we know it should be like, we know the whole video length process and all these things. So yeah, I'm just gonna show you this one. I could have placed two fish, but I just don't want to crowd up my pot, so I just place one fish inside there. So yes guys, this is the process. So you first, you season your fish, then you cut up your seasoning that you want to use, what I call vegetables that you want to include in your brown stew. And then you heat your frying pan, that's what we call it in Jamaica, or your skillet, if that's what you call it, whatever you call it. You get it heated up, then you pour in your oil. You don't have to put any pepper in the oil if you don't want to. I like spice, and most Jamaicans like spice. And then you don't also have to put any garlic in your oil. I choose to, because it gives it flavor. And I also add the thyme to get a little flavor also. So these are options, optional. You don't have to use it if you don't want to, or if you don't like it like that. You don't have to. So don't say, oh, she used this and I don't want this. You don't have to do it, guys. You don't have to. I'm just doing it my way, the way I like it, for sure. Yeah. So guys, I am going to pause the video a little, and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like when it's finished. I don't know if I should really show you, like, when I'm turning it. Maybe I should show you this part of it so you can have an idea. So you just use your lifter and you turn it over like this. And if you don't want to have like those thyme and all these things in your way, you can just remove them from the pot. I don't want to remove them. And that's just my choice, my preference. I don't want to remove them. So yeah, you turn over your fish like that. And you get it golden brown on both sides. This side can brown a little bit more. I think I'm rushing because I'm trying to show you guys. And I don't want the video to be too long. But yeah. So I'm gonna pause it. I just wanted you to see what you do. You flip it over and allow the other side to become brown. Right? So we're getting it really golden brown. So guys, here we have it. One of them is finished frying. And as you can see, it's well done and it's not burnt. And I am about to take out this one, because what we want to do, we want to make sure it's golden brown on both sides, but we don't want it to burn, because burnt food is not good for you. That can give you other illnesses. I'm not a doctor, so I don't want to go into that. But yes, we don't want it burnt or anything. Don't mind me, I like to wipe around my stove because I don't like a messy stove while I cook. And that's just me. Everybody do their thing different. But I like to do this. I don't like to see the mess on the stove or the oil on the stove while I'm cooking. So now, guys, that we have it here, you have it. the beginning of the process and the final part that we all await to make it or turn it into that brown stew fish is coming up. So this is it, golden brown or fried as we say in Jamaica. So we fried it on both sides and we set it aside for the brown stew sauce. So what I'm going to do now, I am going to throw off all of this oil. I'm going to use the same frying pan. We said frying pan in Jamaica and I'm trying to keep it real. But you might say frying pot or you might say skillet. But whatever term you use, it is the same thing or similar thing. So I'm going to throw off this oil because when I'm making my sauce, I don't want any oil in it. That is a big turn off for me when someone prepared. It doesn't matter, even if it's not fish, but whatever, and it is made up of oil. That's not good. That's not healthy. So I poured off all this oil and then I begin the whole process of, you know, like sauteing my vegetables and so forth. You will see it. So guys, I am about to begin the brown stew process. And the first thing that I want to add to the pot, like I said, I don't want a lot of oil, so I just covered it and it seems like I have too much, but I let it stay. I don't like oil like that, right? So I try to use as less as possible. So the first thing I'm going to add is my chopped garlic. I almost said onions. Yeah. And I'm doing it just like we would do it back home. I'm not trying to pretend or put on anything. I'm just going to do it just the way we would do it back home. And the first thing we would do is saute our garlic. And I'm going to turn down my stove a little bit because I don't want anything to burn. And the pot was hot. I am using the same pot because that's what we would do back home. We would rinse it and reuse it. Or sometimes we'll change it. But most time we don't, and that's the truth. I am also going to add my onion. Remember, I told you I have more than one set of onion. And the reason for this is at the end, I want to add some more onions, right? So this is the onion, and you still fry it until it becomes translucent. That's when you know it's ready. So, yeah. So that's my onion and my garlic, and I told you earlier I have some slices of pepper, so I'm going to add my pepper. And somebody might say, but where is the oil? I don't want the oil in it. And you will realize that we'll have the same thing in the end, because I don't want the oil. It's not healthy, and even though it's not like a healthy cooking I'm doing, you still have to try to do healthy stuff. So yeah, I don't want the oil. So that's the onion in it, and I'm stirring it so it can become as translucent as possible. So that's my onion, my garlic, and my scotch bonnet pepper, of course. And to that I am going to add just a little of each of my bell peppers. So I'm going to bring my cutting board here and put in some of the green one, some of the yellow ones, some of the red ones. And I am also going to do some of my orange pepper. So you see we have this kind of mixed color going on here. And I like this to the part colorful. Yes, I do really like that. So yeah, if at this stage you feel like your oil is too tiny or whatever, or it's not sufficient and you want to add some more, you can go right ahead and add it. I don't want it in it. I'm trying to stir fry it. And oh guys, the pot might look dark. It's not because they're black or burnt or anything. It's the type of pot that I am using. The brand is The Rock. So that's why it looks this way. And I have to point out this because I know Jamaicans watch my channel, and sometimes we have to be true. We know how we are and what we will say, and that's just the truth. So yeah, right. So I don't want any oil. Right, I'm gonna leave it a little and then I'll get back to it a little. So guys, now that we have our vegetables nicely sauteed, what you can also add, you can add your carrots, you can add okra if you want. It all depends on what you want. Everybody tends to add what they want. Normally I'll put some okra in it, sometimes I put carrot in it. I'm not putting any of that today. I have okra, but I wanted to steam some fish with it. Well, I have sufficient good use. I just don't feel like putting it in it, let me be real. And I didn't want any carrot in this one. So yeah, I am just doing it as simple as possible, but you can add anything else you desire. Remember, you're cooking for yourself. And guys, even though I had some vegetables on my cutting board, don't practice that if you're cooking for other people, because you don't, especially if you know they're allergic to something, you don't want to have all this and that on the same board, because we're supposed to wash our boards after each use. But yeah, I'm cooking for myself and I'm not allergic to anything in this pot for sure. So guys, and to this saute mix, I am going to put 1.5 cup of water. The reality is, in Jamaica, we're not going to measure anything. We're just going to pour it. But for our sake, I'm telling you, what I use. So it's 1.5 cups of water that I add. I will leave my recipe in my description for those who need it. But right, and to this I am going to add 1/2 tablespoon of seasoning. I want to add flavor, so I add a little seasoning, not much because the fish already contains seasoning. And if you're thinking about health and all these things, you don't have to add too much. So I add that, and yeah, I also want to add some black pepper, but I forget something and I will have to grab it. Give me a second. So guys, I add some black pepper to my mix. I'm going to put about less than 1 teaspoon of salt, because we already seasoned the fish with salt, but I just want to add a little salt to taste. So yeah, so that season that I said I put earlier, it was all from Miss Dash brand, and you can put whatever season you like and desire. I'm using what I like and desire to have in it. So yeah, I add some season. I'm turning up the fire a notch. Yes, I'm turning up the stove a notch, and I didn't put my tomato in. As you realized earlier, I don't ready to add it. Normally I'd stir fry some of it, but I didn't. I will put it at the end, closer to the end of it. So we are going to allow this to come to a boil, but before we allow it to come to a boil, I want to put 1 tablespoon of soy sauce in it, right? So I will be putting that right now, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce to my mix. So yeah, here you have it, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce. You don't want it to be black or anything in that sense, and you don't want it to be too light, so you just want it to be right. Right, and I'm going to put a little tubes of browning. So I add my soy sauce, I add my browning. You don't have to use both. Again, you can use one. So if you only have soy sauce, use it. If you only have browning, use it. The choice is yours. You're cooking for you and your family. You know what they like. And even if you're cooking for someone, as long as it is tasty, it is clean and decent, that's what matters in the end. So use what you have. Don't feel compelled, because this girl right here, Celita, is using this and that. You think you have to use all of that. No, you don't have to. But this is how we do it in Jamaica. And my Jamaican peeps will agree with me. We like things spicy. We like things a certain way. So we're going to do it a certain way. So yeah. So guys, I am going to cover my pot and I'm going to allow this to simmer for the next 10 minutes. So guys, like I said, we like it spicy. So I'm going to add some crushed red pepper to this. Not much of it, just a few, so I can have some pepper seed. Because I like pepper. And also to this, I'm going to add about a tablespoon of ketchup. One tablespoon of ketchup. I'm going to add that to help to thicken my sauce because I'm not using any cornstarch in it. I don't practice that. I try to do it as natural as possible. So I'm going to add that to thicken my sauce. So guys, it's coming along nicely the way I want it. So I'm now going to add my tomatoes to it. Yes, I didn't add it at the start, as you notice. And my reason for that is I didn't want it to be overcooked or anything. So I didn't add it. And I told you I was keeping back some of my vegetables. So I'm going to add some more onions. I'm going to add the remainder of my bell peppers. Alright, because I want to have, you know, this vibrant color going on. To that, I am also going to add a tablespoon of butter. And I need a smaller spoon to get out. So yeah, I'm going to add a tablespoon of butter to this mix. Right. My measuring spoon is trying to hold on to the butter. Why, I don't know. But yeah. So I add a tablespoon of butter, as you can see. And it's just for me alone, so I don't need much of the bone stew sauce that I am making. I don't need a lot. I only have two fish, and we know that the fish has one thing, guys, for those who are not Jamaican, you don't prepare this fish much, this type of fish. The fish sometimes absorb the liquid, so you have to bear that in mind. So yeah, I put the remainder of my season because I wanted it to look vibrant. So I'm going to cover it a little bit and I'm going to add the fish. So guys, there you have it. My sauce is at the consistency that I want it to be personally. So yeah. It's ready and I'm going to serve it, taste it, and tell you how it tastes. If it doesn't taste good, for sure I will tell you. That's who I am. I'm gonna keep it real, but I know for sure it's gonna be lovely. So stay tuned for that part. So guys, here you have it, my brown stew fish, Jamaican style. I served it with a little plain rice. That's what we call white rice in Jamaica, plain rice, right? Because there's no peas. I'm keeping it real. So here you have it. This is my fish and I serve it with some rice and some plantain. I love plantain and I am going to taste the fish and tell you what it tastes like. Like I said, if it doesn't taste good, I'll definitely tell you. But this is it from your girl, Jo. But let us dive into this fish. I want to show you. Guys, look at it. Just... I wish you could see my face, but I want you to see the food. This is really good. Trust me, it is. It's not because I prepared it. It is really good. I have some of the vegetables. A vegetable is crunchy and nice. That is why I said I wasn't putting everything at first. Guys, here you have it. It is really tasty. Tastes really nice. Should not be eating and talking. But I have to tell you, And this is my dinner today. So, thanks for watching. Please come back. Please visit again. Please try this recipe and tell me how it worked out for you. And for my 2 subscribers who requested this recipe, here you go. Try it and tell me all about it. I know for sure one person tasted it before from me. So that person know for sure that it tastes good. So yeah. So guys, again, thanks for watching. And please continue to support my channel. Stay tuned for more videos like this. Bye.